Hello. This is Sarah, the art lead for the game Banish from Video Game Development Association, and I will be giving you a tutorial on how to draw Nestel for the cutscenes team, which will be different from the game itself, in that this style I will be replicating the Sumie ink brushed style, which is like a traditional Japanese way of painting with ink. And first, this here is a rough sketch that I drew earlier, and I will show you all how to stylize in the Sumie style, and I will show you how to draw over roughs. Let's lower the opacity so we don't get distracted by the dark lines. But also, let's experiment with some brushes. Now, I will probably link you some of the brushes that I will use here. And one of them is really good. It's called Sumie Stroke. I'll probably write that down. But it looks like... hold on. It looks like this. Now make sure the opacity, the pressure for opacity is on, so you get this watercolor type effect. You see that? If it's off, then it's like not watercolory, it's like straight up ink. And also the pressure for the stroke size. Now that's a really good looking stroke. You start light, then dark, then light. You want pressure variety. There's also something called a wet watercolor, which looks like... like this. Ooh. It's kind of... wait. Was that the right one? Hold on. Yeah. Specifically, it's called wet watercolor -2 multiply. Probably gonna write it down somewhere. But it looks kind of like this. So you get a really watercolory look and texture. And this is what we want to use to fill in our lines with color. There is also something called a deformation brush. This is a really cool brush. Is a lot of random, it goes in a lot of random directions, as you can see, so you can make some cool effects. But for now, it's unpredictable, so you'd only be using it for like special effects. And there are some extra brushes that add a little bit of watercolor flavor. One of them that I like is called Snow, if I can find it. Is it this one? No. Snow. So it adds a bit, like, a variety of splatters, so you could get that natural watercolor feel. There's also a splash. Let's see. Wait, was it this one? No. No, not this one. Splash one. Sorry. Oh yeah, here it is. So there's that, but use this sparingly, like very sparingly, because it draws your attention a lot. And the last one would be something called jet. Yeah. This could also be used to fill in stuff, depending on what you prefer. This is a lot more defined. And, yeah, that's your introduction to the watercolor brushes that we have. Don't erase with the hard-edged eraser, like this, or else it's really obvious that it's a digital painting. We want to get the watercolor look. So you want to erase with something like jet, which I just had a moment ago, like this. So it's really subtle. Okay? Alright, So I lower the opacity, and I want to start with the Sumier brush. It's a really good basic brush. And what I notice about the Sumier style is that their strokes are very deliberate, and they paint so that they can catch the spirit of things. It's kind of hard to explain, but best I can do is just demonstrate. So I'm going to demonstrate on this drawing that I made of some kind of ninja girl. And let's see. Test it out. Oh, wrong layer. Make sure you're on the right layer. If you don't want to bother this layer, use this. What's this called? Lock image pixels so you don't bother it. So you can't bother it. And I will paint on a new layer. The strokes. Okay. Starting. Ooh, is this the right one? Oh, yeah. Opacity. Toggle the opacity. Pressure. What size is this? Let's start with 20 pixels. So, you want to get the major shapes first. The major contour first. Like, the outline, the very outer outline, and go with the flow. Go with the flow. Make it flow. Like that. Just get the major shapes first. That's really important. Oops. And just flow. And add line weight. Vary your pressure. That way it looks interesting. Just go smooth and steady, just like the painters of the Sumier. Deliberate lines, deliberate strokes. And I'm not going to get the armbands just yet, because that's a detail And you want to get the major strokes, like I said. And just flow. Get a leg. Calves. Each stroke is deliberate, and you have the power of Control Z, so you can erase or undo whatever if you messed up. It's really useful. And also, it's kind of hard for me to get the angle of the leg, so what I do, just like a real drawing, I press R. So when you press R, you can rotate it, so you can make the strokes as you would comfortably be able to do. So that's how you're able to adjust the canvas or manipulate the canvas so to your liking. Gonna edit. Well, not just yet. Oops. And just keep going. Think about what lines will come forward, what lines are going to be hidden behind other lines, like in the fingers. Hands are kind of weird, but that's okay. And now it's time, I think, to get into details. So I want a smaller width of the brush. Let's say you don't have to go half. You can go like 3/4 or 2/3. So before it was 20, now I can make it 15. Doesn't seem to make much of a difference, but yeah. So now I can start getting into details. Get the eyes just right. And you can fill in blacks or very dark spots with your ink if you want to. She has a scar here. And you don't need to go in your roughs. You don't need to go super detailed. Well, actually, no. In the inking stage, this is the inking stage, you don't need to be super detailed. You just want to be deliberate with your strokes. Details. See, there's her neck, and here's her collarbone. It's gonna be really light. Use your knee. And get your toes. Now this, it's going very smoothly because I've had a lot of practice with gesture drawing. So that's a really good thing to study outside of VGDA. And now I can add her lovely armbands. Vary the pressure to add interest. Vary the pressure. Get her hair wraps around the head, her head. And just add to the flow of her hair. Vary the pressure. Oops. But don't make it messy. Don't make it too messy. I can add a bit more of her toes. Let's add an anklet here, just because. And here too. So you see how I varied the pressure, and it just flowed with the form. Make it simple but deliberate. Oh, here she has, her hair is tied with some ribbon thing, so I can experiment with different textures here. It's like ribbon, cool effect. I probably could have done that for the hair too, but it's up to you what texture you want. Sumiye is the basic one that you should start with. Alright, and things look good. I forgot the headband. I should probably fill it in with like Sumiye. Rid of the rough layer. See if it looks right. I kind of want to fix some things here and there. Erase with a brush, a watercolor brush. So it's not quite obvious. Once again, that's Sumiye. That's fine. Now for the coloring. We want to start coloring with the not on white. So I'm gonna first color the background a bit with a watercolor brush. Let's try the wet watercolor too. The game is mostly muted colors. So I can just start filling it in using big shapes. I mean, big strokes. Vary the pressure. Also, maybe wanna go in here with the shadow under her. It's okay if it's a little bit streaky like this. So we want that natural watercolor feel. Go big. But you don't have to go home. Okay. Can go like this. Just for the base. And now make a layer under your sketch layer, your ink layer. And we're gonna start coloring, filling in the character.